Hello, welcome to Istqb Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to see the last activity, that is the test completion activity. So let's start with the test completion. So the first thing which we will see is, as usual, the objective of test completion activity. The objective is to collect the data from the completed test activity. So whatever the activities which we have completed, like in the first stage we have made test specification, so that will be one of the data which we will collect. Test design, that also we will collect. Traceability matrix, that we will collect. All the reports which we have generated, all those things we will collect. So this, at this process we are collecting all the things which we have done till now in the testing process. Then to consolidate the experience, test wares and any other relevant information. So any information which we have got while performing the testing, that we have to store it now here, consolidate here. So this is a step where we are consolidating it. And the last one is at the project milestone, such as software release. So if that particular milestone has received, then what we have to do is we have to complete the project or we have to cancel the test process. Either of these two we have to do, depending upon the what is the condition of our testing. So this is the objective. So this we have to decide here. Okay. So apart from these three objectives, that is to collect all the data, to consolidate all the data, and to decide whether it is we have to release the software or we have to again perform the testing. So that is what we is the objective. Now moving to the activities by doing which we can achieve this objective. So to achieve these objectives, there are certain activities. So let's start with the first activity, that is checking whether all defect reports are closed. So in the test execution, we will find it out that, okay, there are some problem in the software or there are some anomalies available there. And then we have to see that whether all those anomalies which was reported are closed or not. So that is one of the activity of test completion. Then creating a test summary report. So at the end, what we will do is we will create a summary report. How many test cases are passed? How many test cases are failed? What was our coverage and how many test cases we have covered and how many test cases we have not covered, how many of them are automated, how many of them are manual. So all those type of one kind of summary, and if there is any defect, what is the severity of defect, how it is going to impact. So these are the things will be part of the summary report. Or other thing also be like who tested it, which organization has tested it, which date it was tested, when it was started, when it is ended. So all those things will be part of your test summary report. So it will summarize all the things which you have done. Then finalizing and archiving the test environments, test data, test infrastructure and all other test ways. So whatever you have used, whether it is a test specification, test case, the hardware or the software, whatever you have used, all those things what we will do is we will finalize it and we will version control it at this particular step. Why we are doing this is, suppose in future customer tells that in the 50th release, whatever you have done, I want you to reproduce that issue again. So what you have to do is we have to download all this data again and perform whatever the customer is asking you. So that is why it is very important to archive the data. Few more activities are handling over of the testware to the maintenance team, other project team and to the other stakeholders. So whatever is the contract with the stakeholder, as per that, after completion of our test activity, we have to hand it over to him all the things which he needs, and then simply for our reference also we have to give it to the maintenance team so that they will keep it, and when it is required we can take it from them and use it. So that is also one of the activity. Then analyzing the lesson learned from the completed test activity. So whatever activity we did, if we have learned anything out of it, then we have to document that, so that when the next cycle starts or when the next project comes, we will not repeat those mistakes, or we will do it in a better way. So that is why lesson learned is very much important here. And the other one is using the information gathered to improve the test process maturity. And if we see that there was some flaw in the test process, or while doing a planning we have not considered certain things, so those all things we can include it as part of the test learning phase itself. So these are the activities which were there in the test completion phase. So I hope this slide is understood to you now. Just quickly revise it. So in this particular stage, what we do is we collect the data, we consolidate the data and we do a release, or we perform the test again. Then there are activities like we have to check all the defect reports are closed or not. We have to prepare the summary report. We have to finalize all the things which we have used and store it somewhere. Then we have to give some informations to the maintenance team so that we can use it in future. Some information to the stakeholder as per the contract, and then analyzing is whatever mistakes were there or any new things which we have learned and document it so that for next project it will be useful or for next iteration of testing it is useful. And then gathering all the information which could be helpful for improving our test process. So these were the things. And now next, going to the overview. So now just we will see an overview very quickly. So what we have is the overview of closure activity. So we have a specification. With that specification we have done design or implemented everything. Then what we do is we do the execution. After execution, what we do is we do the recording of all the pass result and the fail result. And if we see that everything is fine here, check completion, we do it. Like we will tell that okay, the testing is completed, and what we will do is the coverage is okay and release it to the customer. But if we find that the coverage is too low, then what this in this closure activity, what we will do is we will go to the first step again. We will do some more, we will write some more test cases so that the coverage is good, and we perform all the testing again, and then we release it to the customer, and this information we will provide it to the customer also. So this is it from the test closing activity. Hope you have understood, and with that even I am closing this particular video. Until next video, happy testing.